Go.
Hey, we're here at the McNeil Studios, and today we're going to talk about price discrimination, which discrimination isn't cool, man. And here to talk about this hate mongering is Professor Mark McNeil. Spread the love.
Hate? That's not what this is about. It's about love. Price discrimination. See, sometimes, first of all, price discrimination. In order to price discriminate, a seller has to have some market power. Then, it must be able to identify different groups of people based on their elasticity of demand. It must be able to segregate them, that is, divide them into different individuals or different groups. It's got to prevent resale, that's essential. And it's got to be able to tell a good story because there has to be a good reason for it. But in another video, we talked about perfect price discrimination, where we charge everybody the highest price they're willing to pay based on their elasticity of demand. In this one, we're going to talk about a different type of price discrimination, where you just divide your market into two separate segments. One has a demand curve that is quite inelastic, and the other, their demand is quite elastic. So there's the demand elastic, there's the demand the inelastic group. And why would a firm want to price discriminate? That is, what is the goal of a firm? And that is to maximize total profits. We can talk about whether it's good or bad next. But if, the most common, of course, is something like airline industry. Now, the airlines, in fact, are much more sophisticated about their price discrimination, but this is the simple take on it. Let's say that there are business travelers that their demand would be inelastic because when they have to fly, they have to fly. And then there are the vacation travelers. Their demand is elastic. They have choices about how they take their vacation. So, if they're able to identify the two groups based on elasticity of demand, then what we need is each group's marginal revenue curve, because they're going to charge this group one price and they're going to charge that group one price. So those are the marginal revenue curve. And then let's say that when they fly, the marginal cost for both business people and vacationers is the same. They're both eating the same rotten food and with their chins on their knees. And so, if the marginal cost is the same, then the airline would want to sell this quantity of tickets to the inelastic group. And what price will they charge? Ah, price comes from demand. So this will be the price of the inelastic group, in this case business travelers, and for the elastic group, the vacation travelers, then this is the quantity of vacation tickets they would want to sell. This is the elastic group, and this is the price they would charge them. There's the price for the elastic group. So in this case, the price for this group, segment A, business travelers, will be P sub I for inelastic, and the quantity will be QI. The price for the vacation travelers is P elastic for elastic group and the quantity elastic. But we can see that for sure the group that is more inelastic in its demand will be charged the higher price. And if the seller is able to pull this off, they can increase their total profits. But how do they segment them, and how do they prevent resale? How do they keep vacation travelers from buying tickets and reselling them to the business travelers? Well, they require ID, for one thing. And how else do they manage to do it? They require that you buy your vacation tickets in advance and that you stay over on a Saturday night. And business travelers hate to stay over on Saturday nights. They want to be home with their families and the barbecue. And they don't have the same options to buy ahead that vacationers do. So that's how they prevent resale and segment group. Now, what in the case of, here we have two different, it's the same setup. We have an elastic group. There's the demand elastic, and there's the demand inelastic. And then Here's the marginal revenue. Marginal revenue has twice the slope of the demand curve. But let's say that they're going to give the these guys, the elastic groups, they give them less service, less quality service, and they're going to give extra special stuff, a higher level of service to the to these guys, Group A. So the marginal cost will be higher for the Group A than for the Group B types, because they're providing extra leg room or extra services or something. Okay, in that case, what quantity will this firm want to sell to the inelastic group? That quantity. And what price will they charge? That price for the inelastic group. And for the elastic group, they will charge that. They will produce that quantity and sell to them, and they will charge price P sub E to the elastic group. But I don't know if you can see, the difference between the marginal cost is about that much. But the difference in price is much greater than that. So this is price discrimination, because price discrimination is selling the same service to different groups at prices that don't justify the cost differences. So in this case, the cost difference is only that much, but the price difference is much more substantial than that. So this is another type of price discrimination, and you know, you can get the extra for business, and I mean the extra leg room in coach kind of ticket, or I don't know, business travelers get slightly better this or that. This is a good example too of books, paperback books with or hardback books. Libraries have inelastic demand, and individuals have more elastic demand. And so they sell the hardbound books to the libraries or the groups with more inelastic demand, and they do sell them at a higher price, but they have a hardback to them. So there's cost increases as well. But the price differences are much greater than the cost differences. So that's this type of price discrimination as well. Okay, so have we spread the love here? I'd say that's enough.